Good morning, church. Stand to your feet. It is time to praise the Lord. We're going to sing praises to the name of Jesus. He is the faithful one. We're going to give testimony, and we're going to talk about the promise that he makes, that he is coming back again. Let's sing the name of Jesus. Lift your voices, put your hands together, and let's give him praise. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous man runs into it and is safe. That is a promise. That is the truth. Let's lift him high this morning.
The name of Jesus is a refuge, a shelter from the storm, a help to those who call. The name of Jesus is a fortress, a saving place to run, a hope unshakable. When we fall, you are the Savior. When we call, you are the answer. There is power in your name. There is power in your name. In the name of Jesus, there is life and healing. Chains are broken in your name. Every knee will bow down and our hearts will cry out. Songs of freedom in your name. Oh, in your name.
He is the author of salvation. Make that our prayer.
Bring salvation.
Set you free. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the one who sets us free, and it is in the name of Jesus that we find that. And here's the promise. When we fall, he is our Savior. When we call on him, he is the answer. Let's sing that.
When we fall, you are the Savior. When we call, you are the answer.
Oh, when we fall.
When we fall, you are the Savior. When we call, you are the answer. There is power in your name. There is power.
Oh, there's power.
There is power in your name. There is power in your name. In the name of Jesus, there is life and healing. Chains are broken.
Come on up here, Pastor Wallace.
I'm just coming
Welcome
in from
home, my brother.
I'm just coming in from Canada, church.
Warrior, you're
it's good to have. Do what?
Warrior, you're our arms tired.
No, I'd be a lot thinner if I ran from there. Yes. Church, welcome this morning to worship. We're so glad to have all of you here. I want to tell you a few things that we've got coming up in the coming weeks that you need to know about. First off, how many of y'all been to Lake Day? Raise your hand. All right. We got to greatly increase that number. We usually have a couple hundred that come out to Lake Day every year. We are having it August the 23rd. That is a Saturday. It's a great time of fellowship. It's a great time to meet other members of the church. You guys, there is another whole half of this church that's in this room on the other hour. So it's a great time to meet new families, make some new friends, and fellowship together. You know, Baptists, when we get together, what's the one thing we love to do? We love to eat. See, y'all are good Baptists. So we're going to be eating. That was strong, too. I mean, yeah, if I could get that kind of amen in my message, we'd be doing better. Man. Baptists love to eat, so we have hamburgers, hot dogs that we'll be cooking this week. Here's why I have to make this announcement. In the bulletin, there is a phone number on there. We need you to text, okay? That's the simplest way to sign up. It's the easiest way. Most of us have smartphones. I have a smartphone. I'm not smart, but I'm smart enough to do this. I hope everybody can do this with me. All you got to do is put in that number, text to that number, your family, how many of you are coming for Lake Day. The reason we need that information makes a difference buying hamburgers and hot dogs, whether you need 100, 200, or 300. We hope to have a lot of people out there, so please come. Please make sure that you do that today. If not right now, right this minute, then do it as soon as you leave today. Take this home. Get that number, text to us the information that we need for you to be signed up. The greatest thing about Lake Day isn't the food. It's not even the fellowship together with believers. For me, it's that one time a year that we get together and do baptisms out publicly. So that is a day that we baptize right there in Carr Lake. If you've not been baptized, if you're here under watch care, still looking to be baptized, it's a great day to do that. All you need to do is call the office, set it up. We do baptisms out at the lake that Saturday. So that's coming up the 23rd. Of August. And if you're a guest with us today, I especially want to take a moment, welcome you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being here with us today. When you walked in, you got a bulletin. Inside that bulletin, there's a guest information sheet. If you'll take a second and please fill that out. It just takes a moment. That gives us a record of your visit. The reason we want that record, we want to get in touch with you. We want to know more about you and your family. We would love to be able to pray for you and your family. We want to tell you about the great things that are happening here at Hephzibah. So especially if you're looking for a new church home, please give us the opportunity to meet you face to face or to talk to you by phone and to tell you what God is doing here. But we wanted to start our service by saying welcome to all of you. And I've made you stand enough. Why don't you sit down? I should have done that a minute ago. Miss Kim Lumley has a quick message she'd like to share with you as well.
Good morning. I'm Kim Lumley, and I am the face of local missions here at Hephzibah, and I have two awesome opportunities for you to join with me. If you'll look at the screen behind me, in our community, we have partnered with the St. Eugene's Catholic Church and the Brown Bag Ministry to make brown bag lunches and sandwiches every Saturday they do this year round. Yesterday, Nathan and Justin Sproul and Jackson and Savannah Watt and their dad and my Will and I and some other people made 950 bologna sandwiches in an hour and 10 minutes. It's a nice, isn't that great? It is a great little assembly line. You go in. It's every Saturday at 9 o'clock at St. Eugene's Catholic Church for about an hour, hour and a half. It is all that you need to be there for. It is an awesome way. $68 is what Hephzibah is committed to donate. One Saturday, the first Saturday of every month, $68 is all it cost us to make 950 sandwiches. We fed 950 people for $68. So I'd like your money, first of all. Second of all, we'd love for you to go and volunteer and make sandwiches, go out and deliver the bags. Second opportunity, we are partnering with the Boys and Girls Club and area churches this year for our book bag event. That's August 23rd. It is the same day as Lake Day. If you've already decided Lake Day is not your thing, well, Jesus has got something different for you. So we'd love for you to go be at the Boys and Girls Club at 11 o'clock. It's going to be for about 3 or 4 hours. We will be collecting school supplies. Hephzibah is donating the water that day. We'll need volunteers to go and help hand that out. If you need any questions answered, please call me or Nellie Smith. If you'd like to donate the money, you can give it to me, or you can designate on your envelope local missions. Thanks.
Okay. Thank you, Miss Kim. There you go, Brother Kevin. We're going to stand together, and we're going to greet one another, and then we're going to continue in worship. Listen, we're going to talk about the Lord's return today. We're going to be ready. We're going to be working. We're going to be worshiping when He returns, and I pray that right now we'll worship Him with all that we have. So greet each other, and we'll continue.
God is faithful. He has honored every promise He's ever made. The promise we're talking about today is that He is coming back. Let's praise Him for His faithfulness. Let's sing this out, church.
Promise maker, promise keeper, You finish what You began. Ever faithful.
Until then, we sing the gospel, we speak the gospel, we go and tell the gospel. Church, right now, want us to sing it. One day when heaven was filled with his praises, he came.
Rising, he justified freely forever.
glorious day.
Amen. And it's that glorious day that we await. It's that glorious day that we're talking about today. Today we're going to ask the question, when he comes back, what will he find us doing? Where will we be? Are we going to be ready? From now to the time that Jesus Christ comes back, here's one thing I know that he shared with us. That we're to go and make disciples of all nations. That we're to go and make sure that they know the truth of the song that we just sang. That Jesus came and he suffered and he bled and he died. Not a sinner, sinless. Died in our place, was buried in our tomb. But praise God, on the third day he rose again. And because of that, we have the promise of life. I believe with all my heart that every person should hear that truth, should have opportunity to respond to the love of God through his son, Jesus Christ. And that's why we go. This week, you remember, we have a team that's in Moldova. Continue to pray for them. The blessing for them this week was we've been praying for a harvest. We've been praying that God would send us those people that are ready to receive the good news of Jesus Christ. We picked this partnership because they weren't looking to us to solely support everything that was happening in Moldova. They're passionate about church planting and reaching people there in Moldova. Jason found out it stressed them a little bit because of planning. But listen, in the end, listen to the blessing this is. We raise money up here. You know, we raise basically $6,000 for us to get 150 students to camp. They raised money over there in Moldova to get an additional 50, 60 students to be able to come as well. So they're going to have the opportunity to witness and share and have camp for another 50, 60 students because of the generosity of the churches in Moldova and the churches here in the States. Thank you for giving. Thank you for praying. But this week we send off another team as well. As this team's coming back from Moldova, one got back from Canada last night. We had one go out Saturday. We have another one going out this Saturday. So if you're part of Canada Missions, if you're part of the VBS this week, will you come forward? We had a lot first service. I don't know how many in this service. I know we had a ton in first. And I'm going to ask their families to come up as well. Their spouses, Don, get up here. Any of you others that are here, Clint Andrews, why don't you come on up? Because I'm going to ask you to pray, brother. Any family that's here that wants to come stand with them as well, we had probably 2-3 times this many in first service. These are the folks and the families who will be going to Canada this week. So I want us to pray them off. I want us to lay some hands on them. So church, if you're willing, will you come forward? Will you put a hand on them with me? And we're going to ask Brother Clint to pray for this team that's going. They'll be doing VBS this week, working with families and churches in Canada. Pray for Moldova, Clint, as well. And I want to give you another good report. Greg Zechman came back this week. I mean, it's awesome to consider what God is doing this summer through this country church. Greg was off in the Amazon this week with his son Graham, mapping sections of the Amazon so mission work could continue out there, witnessing and sharing in these villages. And when I say remote places of the earth, when Jesus said, go to the ends of the earth, that's where they went this week, up river. On boats, sleeping in crazy conditions, hiking in crazy conditions, but God truly blessed. And I look forward to hear what Greg has to say as well on the 24th of August as we share all these stories. So, Brother Clint, would you lead us in prayer?
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, as we come to your house today to worship you, there's no other place we'd rather be but here. But, Lord, we're ascending church. You made us ascending church. We're the hands and feet of Jesus. Lord, as we have these teams on the ground, I just ask for your blessing and your loving hand of protection on them as they travel to and from. Lord, I ask that their words will be your words, that their teachings will be your teachings, and if just one heart is touched, if one small child and one young adult is moved towards you, so very worth it. Lord, I ask that this church will pray for those in need, Lord, of your name. Lord, there's just so many people out there that don't know you like we do. And Lord, we need to make an impact. This church needs to make an impact. Lord, I pray for the safety of those as they leave. Lord, as they come back, it's in your beautiful heavenly name I pray. Amen.
Amen. You guys know you're in our prayers all week long. In church, as we take this offering, I want to remind you, You play a part in this story, not just those who get on a plane and go, but many of you have given generously to help those who are going be able to go. Most of you have been praying for these mission trips as we've led up to them all summer long. I want you to know that every time a child is blessed in a Baptist children's home around the state, every time families are touched when there is disaster around the world through Baptist Men's disaster ministry, anything and everything that Baptists do, when you give money to this church, it goes towards mission. It goes towards ministry. It goes to making an impact around the world. So I would ask you today, give generously. This is the mission that God sent us to do. Today as you give, let it be an act of worship. The Bible says that He loves a cheerful giver. And I want you to know that we have a God who gives, a God who blesses, a God who will take what we offer up to Him and He will multiply it and use it in ways we could never imagine. So as these ushers are coming, I want you to pray and I want you to ask yourself, God, what gift do I give worthy of Your name, worthy of King Jesus today? Brother John Jeffries, would you pray for this offering today?
Our most gracious and kind Heavenly Father, we are just so thankful for the opportunity that You have given us that we can come together today for this time of worship. We know, dear Lord, that all we have is Yours. And I just pray that we will be the good steward that You would have us to be. Not only of our monies, but of our time and everything that we do, dear Lord, that we will do for You and in accordance with Your will. And as we come this morning bringing our tithes and offerings, I pray that we do so with cheerful hearts, for as Aaron said, You love a cheerful giver, and I pray that that's what we are, dear Lord, for we know that You will bless these monies and use them in accordance with Your will. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Join in this singing of a prayer.
Just as I am without one plea, but that Thy blood was shed for me, and that Thou bidst me come.
Sing this next verse. Praise Him for the cross.
Just as I am, I would be lost, but mercy and grace my freedom brought, and now to glory. come broken to be mended. I come mended to be healed. I come desperate to be rescued.
I come empty to be filled. I come guilty to be pardoned by the blood of Christ the Lamb.
And I'm welcome with open arms.
God, we come before you this morning thanking you for Jesus who came full of grace, full of truth. Lord, the grace is, Lord, that we can come just as we are. And the truth is, you love us so much you don't want to leave us that way. So, Lord, as we come to this time, block out the distractions. Lord, we want to focus and hear clearly from your word this morning. I pray for Pastor Aaron as he speaks. Lord, you know the distractions that are waiting on us that are just lurching to take our minds and our attentions and our focus off of you. This morning I pray for just a brief time that we can be still, know you, worship you, and hear your word. Speak through your Holy Spirit, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.